give him my time, so I give him my heart. If the city love me, then they're really a star.
I guess I didn't realize how time intensive it actually was gonna take.
The extent of it
and like not having any time to do stuff. Even just like sleep, honestly.
In juniors, you go to every tournament and you know for a fact you're playing. In college, it's like, okay, I'm gonna go to this tournament. I may or may not play, but it's still my team that's playing. So like, I'm still here and I'm still present.
In the juniors, when you have like your own team, like your coach, your parents, and everyone that like...
You're allowed to be way more selfish.
Yeah, you're super selfish and everyone's there to make you win. Yeah. And then like you go into like a team sport and you're like, oh, I have to like work on things myself.
Yeah.
No one's telling me what to work on.
Yeah. Like you have to bring it every time in college time.
Yeah.
Every time you go out to play a match, it's like, you gotta bring your best for it.
Started playing tennis in Italy. All of like the siblings play tennis. So it was a lot easier for my mom to take everyone to the same place. So I would just like play tennis with my mom while like waiting for my brother to finish practice, and I was like three. So it was just like natural for me to go into tennis.
I originally got into tennis because of my dad. Like he put me in it because he just liked the sport. He thought it was fun. And then when I was young, my dad passed away. I was lucky enough to grow up near a really great tennis academy where there were a lot of kids my age who were really good. And the coaches cared about me as an individual a lot. For my mom who worked, it was like a place where she kind of just put me. And then I just kind of got thrown into this super competitive world, and then all of a sudden playing college and like at the collegiate D1 level was like my goal and what I wanted to do.
Growing up, my parents being professional tennis players and my coaches is honestly like very difficult, more so on the balance side, because I had to balance like them being my parents and also having them be my coaches. There was no like separation between the two. They like knew everything about my life and also on the tennis court.
My parents actually met because they exchanged numbers to be hitting partners for each other. So I felt like I was like born into tennis. Definitely really nice playing with my parents, just because like I didn't have to like spend money on lessons for those years, and I developed a lot. Afterwards, I joined an academy for a few years, and then I eventually moved to San Diego for tennis with my mom. And there, I just played practice matches every day.
We have very different experiences.
Yeah.
I would say we lean on each other so much mentally. Tennis is such a different sport than any other sport. It's so individual and it's so mental, and nobody really understands that except for us.
We're also like forced to lean on each other in a way, in a positive way, because of all the time that we spend with each other. It's like you practice, you travel to all these places together, you end up knowing every little thing about each other.
For a long time, I feel like a lot of my value of myself came from tennis and how I did in tennis.
Yeah.
Coming into college, it was weird to have an adjustment period where, you know, I wasn't playing every weekend. So for me, I'm like, oh my gosh, like, who am I now? And that was really hard, but was super lucky to also be going through it with people who were also investing. So we all kind of felt the same way, and that was super comforting.
Tennis is such a momentum-based sport, and you might feel down for whatever reason. You can see your teammate like cheering and working really hard and being in their match. That can fuel you.
Yes, you're accountable for everything. You're accountable for your wins and your losses. Being on the team, you're like, okay, I could just stop, but I can't because there are other people here.
Definitely stayed in matches longer than I would have.
Yeah.
Because I know that everyone's like watching me, and I'm like, you owe it to everyone on the team beside yourself to like give it all you got.
You're not playing for yourself anymore. Now it's like you're playing for like other people. You don't want to let other people down.
The advice that I would give myself for that transition freshman year would just be to like be okay with things not going exactly how you envisioned it.
I think I would tell myself that it doesn't matter, everything's gonna be okay. Because coming in, I think I took everything a lot more to the heart than now. But like after being able to like play a little bit more and like realizing that I have my team to kind of rely on sometimes, like I don't need to be perfect, and like losses are fine, it's failures, and you kind of learn from them.
I wish I could remind myself to be here for the excitement, like be here for the positives, you know, because at the end of the day, like being on a college tennis team is such a blessing. Like we literally get to travel the world.
Something that I would tell myself is to not have imposter syndrome regarding like school and academics. We're all here for a reason, and we got here.
Yeah. to not doubt
different ways, but like don't doubt your abilities, because I think that everyone deserves to be here. So